Allon, I love the piece that we have from Marcelo Claure, basically saying, I'm so done with the hype around AI. I want to see companies using it, fixing a world problem. He says, you're doing it. How are you doing it?
Well, we decided to focus on a big problem called primary care. That's the access to healthcare. There's about a billion primary care visits a year in America. People have chronic conditions, they have preventative needs, and they have acute care. And we built software that allows you to engage with patients and with your electronic medical records and with doctors, and it allows doctors to focus on making the decisions and engaging with patients. That's really, really tough to do. You need to build a lot of intelligence into the system. But that allows health systems to now to integrate AI and clinical AI in their day-to-day, in their primary care. For example, we're integrated into Cedars-Sinai, so we can manage you remotely with primary care, but we can also integrate you into specialist test labs in a world-class health system.
Now, people will recognize you because you're a co-CEO of Wix. You're also co-founder CEO of Vroom. You've been there, done that, taking companies public. I'm interested as to this particular problem that you're trying to solve. How are you seeing the efficiency gains? How are you measuring your success at this earlier stage, other than being able to raise funds?
I think that's a great question. I think the main focus always needs to be on quality. It needs to be better quality. And everybody always complains about healthcare. It's so expensive, it's so tough to be in front of doctors. So the three things we look at, first is quality. B, can we make the doctor's life easier? Do they need to spend much less time collecting information, organizing it? Imagine having this really smart resident there who prepared everything there. Now the doctor can come in, can focus on the judgment, can focus on the patient. So you're saving a lot of time, so productivity improvements are large. And then there's also access. We provide it 24/7, just like you'd want to get from your health system. And it needs to be grounded in your electronic medical record. We need to be able to provide you personalized medicine. So you need to bring all those pieces together, and they need to go hand in hand.
Allon, critically, the point with K-Health is that the diagnosis, treatment, or onward referral to a specialist is still determined by a human being. But are you able to share any data about the sort of success rates of treatment by using the platform and then having a means for a doctor to say, okay, this is the patient before me, this is the information I have available, this is what we're going to do?
Well, we can see everything anonymously that the doctor does, and we can learn from it. Bear in mind, the doctor, if new things could happen, new symptoms can appear down the road. Sometimes doctors change their diagnosis. So yes, you're right, the doctors are making the diagnosis and treatment decisions. But we're letting doctors essentially have a co-pilot that does a lot of the basic work, but also some of the nuanced insights that can help doctors make decisions. And then we have this look back, the ability to look at outcome data and see the patients regularly. When you work, for example, in Cedars-Sinai, where we're integrated, you are getting an aside primary care, just like anywhere else. It's just 24/7, and you can manage this directly, and you can get, again, the prescription, the referral, anything else you'd expect and need, but now you have just much more convenience, and all you need is your insurance.